An exchange amendment bill 2023.
The Shadow Minister of Finance, Muhammad Mwanga Chivumbi, led his colleagues to put up a spirited fight against the passing of the controversial supplementary budget schedule number 1 for the 2022-2023 financial year Parliament on items that had been rejected by Parliament.
It has stretched our sympathy beyond a point of satiety, and we are saying enough is enough. Therefore, we stand firmly to reject an expenditure which the majority committee rejected.
MPs were opposed to approval of this supplementary, where over 274 billion shillings was allocated to Atiak Sugar Factory for capitalization and 48 billion shillings that was allocated to Munyonyo Commonwealth Resort for construction of the conference center to host the forthcoming non-aligned movement conference to be hosted in Uganda.
This parliament approved money for a hospital in Lua. We're almost at a gunpoint that we have made the commitment for Pinet.
Now, did you see a gun here?
I am using the language, the meaning, the parliamentary language. Madam Speaker, I am looking at the meaning in the language I am using. Then we have another Atiak here, another lady, Amina. Maybe this parliament should interest itself in finding the relationship between the president who is proposing these sums of money with these women.
However, when the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, put the matter to vote, the 1.434 trillion supplementary budget which had stalled was approved by the House.
Of recommittal, you say? No, I am... Second, I was diverting us. Honourable members, I put a question that this House recommits two expenditure items as proposed by Honorable Chivumbi. Those in favor say aye, and to the contrary, nay.
There was drama as the Speaker left the House, only to be reminded that she had not adjourned it ceremoniously.
Tomorrow, the Lady Justice Arach Amoko will be brought to the House. Have a blessed evening. House adjourned to 2 tomorrow.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.